That's Mark Francois. Welcome to Talk Drive. How are you?
I'm fine. Sorry, the Chinese jamming seems to be getting worse, Jeremy. But I'm just pleased to be with you.
Good man. You haven't got a wax jacket on, you far right thug, have you?
I do own a wax jacket, but I'm not wearing it now.
You're a far right.
And I'm not wearing wellies either, to avoid confusion.
Shadow Defence Minister, I was just saying, Mark, and I genuinely mean this. I've sat here for a good couple of years since this government came to power, and I will never cease saying the next line. Your party messed up to such an extent that these people got in, and I find it shocking. I'm old enough to remember the last time they were in. They seem to be attacking the things that I call are the very basics and important basics of this country. Pensioners, the rural community yesterday. And on the day that we allow those shadow missiles to be fired by Ukraine into Russia, when many people, Mark Francois, would say that Europe is not on the precipice of World War III, but it's in a very dangerous and volatile position, John Healey thinks it would be a good idea to announce £500 million worth of defence cuts to a defence that, frankly, isn't up to scratch anyway. It beggars belief, man, doesn't it?
It kind of does. If you believe that the role of armed forces is to save life by deterring war, by persuading any potential aggressor not to start because they wouldn't win, then cutting our capability like this the day after the 1,000th day anniversary of the invasion of Ukraine sends absolutely all the wrong signals to the likes of Vladimir Putin. We will not deter a man like Putin, an ex-KGB colonel, by taking warships and helicopters out of service. This is exactly the wrong thing to do. And the reason that they've done it is because they will not commit to a timeline for spending 2.5% of GDP on defence. If they'd done that, if the Treasury had allowed it, they would have had the money to avert doing this. They haven't granted the money, so they've had to make these cuts. And if you're Vladimir Putin, you will be encouraged by this, not deterred.
Well, it's interesting because Putin is, and I'll bring Peter Carbell in, Putin's foreign minister warns this is escalation. And people are labelling this guy as, you know, Europe prepares for war. Germany reveals plans to mobilise its national defence force and 800,000 NATO troops after that nuke threat. Our response, Peter Carbell, Mark will respond to this as well, is to try and cut more off defence, a defence that's frankly on its backside anyway. It's beyond me.
Well, let me ask Mark Francois a question. Mark, there seems to be in Westminster a consensus in regard to Ukraine and supporting Ukraine and giving Ukraine a lot of money, including from British taxpayers. Should at least some of that money be spent here at home on our own military, or are you happy with the amount of money this government is giving to Ukraine?
We need both. We, relative to the size of our army, we have given more equipment to Ukraine than anybody else. Mm. We were the first to give them tanks. We gave them heavy 155mm artillery. We gave them a lot of our reserves of ammunition. So that's why Rishi Sunak announced some months ago that we would increase defence spending to 2.5%, and we put a time on it to 2030, so that gives you a linear increase in the defence budget, and that money was for two reasons. One was to replenish the equipment and the ammunition that we'd given to the Ukrainians, who were putting it to good use. And the other element of that money was to begin rearming as a nation. Mm. So that's why we put that money up front, and crucially, we put a timeline on it so the MOD could plan.
But Labour
had just said, all right, we will mirror that. We'll do 2.5% by 2030. If Labour had mirrored 2.5% by 2030, which is what we'd promised, they wouldn't be having to make 500 million of cuts today.
But you can see, Mark, can't you, people sitting at home thinking, we're giving lots of money to Ukraine. They may agree with that, they may disagree with that. But here at home, senior military people, serving and former, are saying that were Britain to be invaded tomorrow, we couldn't defend ourselves.
Why are you making it just about Ukraine? Let's make it that bigger question and put this to Mark Francois. Yesterday, the attack on the rural community, another absolutely abject decision by this government, the aim, whether you argue that their argument 500 farms, actually it's thousands, they got their figures wrong, that was 565 million that would save. This today is 500 million. Where do you, Mark Francois, and the Tory party stand on the front? I'm really strong on this. We're giving £13.5 billion of foreign aid. We can include Ukraine in that. Let's include India. We don't need to be giving India money for projects for I don't know what, transgender birthday parties somewhere outside Calcutta. I've made that up. But you know what? It really hacks me off. Our military's taking a bashing. Our pensions are taking a bashing. In fact, almost anybody who's done anything for this country, the farming community that provide our food are taking a bashing. I am happy to support Ukraine, but why are we giving countries who don't need money, Mark, money when people in this country need it? We need it as a society. That's my point.
Well, when I'm not going to rerun the Tory leadership contest, we've had that now, but both Kenny Badenoch and Robert Jenrick said that they wanted us to raise our defence spending to 3%, and a way of doing that, certainly Robert said, was to take some of that money out of the aid budget and to funnel it into defence. I think that makes a lot of sense. Mm. One of the reasons we're giving that money to Ukraine is, bluntly, they're closer to the problem.
Yeah.
They are the people who are having their power stations attacked by Russian missiles. They are the people who have had their hospitals, even children's hospitals, attacked by the Russian armed forces. They're fighting for us too. They're fighting for freedom. They're fighting for democracy. And let's be really clear-eyed about this. Vladimir Putin is on the record as saying he wants to recreate, in effect, the Russian Empire. He described the collapse of the Soviet Union as the greatest geopolitical disaster of the 20th century. He has been absolutely clear about what he's trying to do. So if we don't stop him in Ukraine, we'll have to stop him in the Baltic states. And if we don't stop him in the Baltic states, we'll have to stop him in Poland. And by that stage, you really would be into something that looks like World War III. So far better to support the Ukrainians and stop him where he is, rather than have to spend a vast fortune, much more money, stopping him later.
Quick question for you. This 500 million defence cuts, ships, drones, two amphibious assault ships, frigates, tankers, 14 Chinook helicopters, 17 Puma helicopters. People are telling me that these are old. If these are being decommissioned, why don't we just give these to Ukraine?
Well, we might be able to give some of that equipment to Ukraine. And that was suggested. We suggested that to the Secretary of State today in the Commons. And basically, he said he would get back to us on that. Mm. But in terms of our own military capability, getting rid of those two amphibious assault ships, Bulwark and Albion, they were in reserve. But in wartime, we could rapidly have reconstituted them and used them. Once they're gone, they're gone. It takes years to build a warship. And the all-party House of Commons Defence Committee in 2018 looked at this issue. I served on the committee at the time. I was part of the report. In fact, I've got the report here. The committee concluded that to get rid of those two ships would be, and I quote, militarily illiterate.
Wow.
And that was an all-party committee. So Labour have just taken a militarily illiterate decision. They are cutting the Royal Navy because they won't commit to a date for 2.5%. And that decision will be welcomed in Moscow.
Other question for you. British Storm Shadow missiles are now being fired, long-range missiles, Peter, aren't they, into Russia?
Yes.
Permission has been given. Where do you and your party stand on that? Do you support that?
Yeah, we have said that if the government decided to use Storm Shadow or to allow Storm Shadow to be used by the Ukrainians against targets in Russia, we would support that. So, yes, we do. And the media are reporting that it would appear that British Storm Shadows have been used. My boss, the Shadow Defence Secretary, James Cartledge, raised this in Parliament this afternoon. We've invited the government to make a statement to the House of Commons later today or tomorrow to give Parliament more details. Obviously, for security reasons, there's only so much the government can say. We appreciate that. But there will be massive public interest in what is being done. and therefore we think it would be appropriate for the government to make a statement tomorrow. But to reiterate, we had already said on the record that if the Ukrainians wanted to use those British Storm Shadow missiles to defend themselves against Russians who were bombing their cities, then we would support that, and we do.
OK, couple more questions, Pete.
Mark, Keir Starmer has said that he doesn't want to confirm or deny whether this has actually happened. We've heard this from various other sources. I mean, you're saying perhaps there should be a statement to him, to Parliament by him or by John Healey, the Defence Secretary. I mean, surely keeping that ambiguity would actually help tactically in Ukraine?
Well, I think if those missiles have been used against Russian targets, then the Russians will know about it.
Yeah.
So in that sense, we're not telling them anything that they don't already know.
Okay, fair enough.
But you're quite right in a way, but you do have to be careful in these matters about how much information you give. We completely understand that, but nonetheless, we do think there are some things at least that the government could tell Parliament, and as far as they can go, for security reasons, we think they should make a statement tomorrow.
I'm more outspoken. I don't think they know what they're doing, which leads me to my final question, Mark Francois. We've been very honest on this station about the shortcomings of your party and the government, and I don't think the Labour Party won the last election. I think you lot lost it. Do you think John Healey's doing a good job as Defence Secretary, sir?
I respect John Healey. I've known John Healey for many years, and I have a lot of time for him, as we would say in Parliament. I think his defence team, they are all good and honourable people. The problem is, Jeremy, they haven't got pull in Starmer world. None of them are part of Starmer's inner circle. So these cuts are ultimately driven by the Treasury. It's Rachel Reeves and her department that are effectively pressuring the MOD to make these economies. So even though Healey, I think, is a decent man doing his best, happy to say that on the record, he's not really running the show and he's not really got the inside track with Keir Starmer. If he did, I think they wouldn't have done this.
Mark Francois, brilliant. Thank you so much indeed. Shadow Defence Secretary, the new look Tory frontbench.